my dear children. Welcome to Hidaya Online Class. I am Prasida, your social science teacher. So let's start our social science class. Okay. In the last class, we had completed our fifth chapter. Today, we are moving to a new unit, World of Diversities. World of Diversities. വൈവിധ്യങ്ങളുടെ ലോകം. Do you know what is the meaning of diversity? Yes, diversity means variety or being different. Okay, diversity means variety or being different. Students, you know we are living in the world of diversities. Diversities exist not only in the flora but also in fauna, human life, etc. അതായത് എന്താണ്, സസ്യങ്ങളിൽ മാത്രമല്ല ജന്തുജാലങ്ങളിലും ജനജീവിതത്തിലൊക്കെ എന്താണ് ലോകത്ത് ഇത്തരത്തില് വൈവിധ്യങ്ങൾ നിലനിൽക്കുന്നുണ്ട് അല്ലെ. ദിസ് ഡൈവേഴ്സിറ്റീസ് ഹാവ് ഇവോൾവ്ഡ് ഇൻ അക്കോർഡൻസ് വിത്ത് ദ ക്ലൈമാറ്റിക് ക്യാരക്ടറിസ്റ്റിക്സ് ഓഫ് ഈച്ച് പ്ലേസ്. റീജിയൻസ് ഓൺ ദി എർത്ത് സർഫേസ് ദാറ്റ് ഷെയർ ഓൾമോസ്റ്റ് സിമിലർ ക്ലൈമാറ്റിക് ക്യാരക്ടറിസ്റ്റിക്സ് ആർ നോൺ ആസ് ക്ലൈമാറ്റിക് റീജിയൻ. Okay, all of you clear? Okay. Students, you have learned about the continents in the earlier class. Each of these continents has different climatic regions. Let us see a few of them. Okay. Now, see this picture. These are pygmies. The pygmies are forest dwellers. They are mainly seen in Congo River Basin in Africa. This region included in equatorial climatic region, the pygmies have short stature and a dark complexion. They dearly love and care for the forest. Cassava or tapioca is their staple food. They also eat hunted meat and gathered fruits. They often wear deer skin or leaves as cloths. They build semicircular houses out of branches of tree and broad leaves. Okay, that is clear that the nature influenced the pygmy's lifestyle. Okay, all of you understand? Okay. Okay, students, how does the nature influence the pygmy's lifestyle? Yes, really good. Pygmies use natural resources directly for their food, clothing and shelter. Cassava or tapioca is their staple food. They also eat hunted meat and gathered fruits. They often wear deer skin or leaves as cloths. They build houses out of branches and trees and broad leaves. Okay, all of you clear? Okay. Dear students, do you know what is equatorial region? Equatorial regions are located in a belts around the equator and covers about the 6% of earth surface. They are often towards lowland and tropical wet climate. It includes Amazon lowland of South America, the Congo basins of Africa, Southeast Asian countries like Malaysia, Indonesia, etc. Okay, shall we check some special features of the Congo basin in Africa? The pygmies mainly dwell. This place is located between 10 degrees south and 10 degrees north of the equator. High atmospheric temperature throughout the year and daily afternoon showers with thunder and lightning. Okay. Dense evergreen vegetation consisting of big trees, climbers, thick undergrowth, moss, vanda and so on. Okay, diverse fauna. Okay, all of you clear? Okay. What may be the causes for the above mentioned peculiarities in the Congo basin? Okay, students, you have already learned that the distribution of sunlight is not uniform everywhere. It is the proximity of these regions to the equator that causes the such a special feature in this region. This causes the luxuriant plant and animals diversity here. The Amazon River Basin in South America and the South East Asian countries like Malaysia and Indonesia also experience the similar climate because these places are located very near to the equator. Okay, the aboriginal tribes of the Amazon River Basin in South America, the Semangs of Malaysia and the Kabus and Dayaks of Indonesia are also forest dwellers like the pygmies. Okay, all of you clear? Okay. These places are located between 10 degree north and 10 degree south of the equator. This region is known as the equatorial climatic region. The equatorial climatic region is generally sparsely inhabited by, okay, this region is located between 10 degree south and 10 degree north of the equator. So, high atmospheric temperature throughout the year and daily afternoon showers with thunder and lightning. Okay, dense forest is another feature of this region. So, equatorial climatic region is sparsely inhabited. Okay, students, that's all for today. We will continue to this chapter. For next class, have a nice day. Okay, thank you.